Okay, where are we going now?
Well, surf's up. With our scorching browser at the ready, we're gonna surf the net.
The internet is really only powered by a handful of things. Cats, animated GIFs of Jennifer Lawrence falling down, cats, James Franco's ego, more cats, and babies.
Depending on how old you are, at a certain age, your Facebook, your Instagram feed just fills up with pictures of babies sleeping,
crying, in adorable Smurf hats, ignoring dad's alcohol problem, and ironically reading books from recently dead authors.
But does this make me a bad parent? I mean, when my child turns 15, what's he gonna think of me? What's he gonna do?
There is now a growing movement of parents determined to keep any and all trace of their kids off the net.
The reason I don't put my kids online is because I don't view that the risk versus reward is ultimately worth it. The reward's pretty obvious. Your kid's stuff's online and you can share that with friends and family and whoever. But there are plenty of other ways to do that that are an awful lot more secure.
Now, Alex is hardly a technophobe. Aside from having three kids aged 8, 10 and 12, he's also an award-winning technology journalist.
How would I feel if suddenly my parents burst into my Facebook account, published loads, you know, hundreds, maybe thousands of photos of me as a kid that could be, you know, embarrassing, socially awkward, even damaging to my career? That would suck, and I don't want that for my kids. You actually give out, and a lot of people do this unconsciously, they give out a lot of personal data about their kids that they wouldn't even give out about themselves. People protect their date of birth because, you know, they want that information to be private. But then they'll throw up, here's a picture of little Benny's sixth birthday party. Doesn't take a genius to work out that if it's his sixth birthday party and you've just put it up and you extrapolate back 6 years, well, that's his date of birth. How often, you know, when you've got to prove your identity to someone over the phone, do they say, right, well, can we get your date of birth, please, Mr. Fennell?
There's now a burgeoning category of websites, applications, wearable technology, even televisions that rely on facial recognition. There's even an app called NameTag that'll let you scan faces. It'll immediately do a search online and return back basic biographical information right there on your phone.
And that's got implications for all sorts of things. People can use it for fraud. I don't necessarily want my kids, you know, signed up by some Russian gangster for 7,000 Visa cards. For identity theft, again, whilst it's a wild extrapolation, I admit, I don't necessarily want, you know, the Israeli security services using my kids' identity for a hit squad.
They've even started using the same basic technology to identify sex offenders because I literally can't imagine how that could possibly go wrong. So, if you have now been sufficiently scared into deleting your child off the web, the question then becomes,
what you do with that social media footprint?
There are things like Account Killer and similar that will show you how to do this, but it's always on a case-by-case basis and it is a difficult task to do, especially if you're particularly widely socially spread.